With all of our trials and errors and huge mistakes along the way, we decided to do things a little differently, and we made this model to make sure everything goes together right. Another problem was the wood that we chose. Although it looked really good for painting and finishing, it turns out that it was quite brittle because it was lots of pieces glued together to form a sheet. We've now switched to a laminate wood, which we'll show you later, that is made of multiple layers and generally used for furniture. We're pretty confident the chair is going to come out strong and look good. Stay tuned because we're finally going to get this chair right. The wood we originally used, although it looked nice for finishing, was made of a bunch of boards that were glued together. This made it quite brittle and easy to break. We're now switching to a laminated wood that looks good for finishing, but also is made up of multiple layers of thin sheets. This wood is going to be much stronger for our chair. So Denny, do you have the G-code ready? What do you have going on here?
Yeah, so the G-code is ready. I just run the simulation of three tool packs. Just do it again. So that's going to be the, that's not going to be the order, the actual order. You can pick which
tool pack
we want to do.
So like we said, we're going to cut out the first N ones. Why is it going over the board a little bit? Is that okay? Oh, that's right, because the bit hangs over the side, but
yes.
Right, okay.
And you can make a little bit quick as well, because we cannot wait to see this chair done.
So. Yeah, all the attempts we've done, it's about time we get it finished, right?
Oh yeah.
In this design, we've made a few improvements. We've thickened the sides a little bit to make them a little stronger. We've measured the holes really accurately so all the joints are tight. So we've gone through and really kind of cleaned up our design, and that's the beauty of the mistakes that we made. Even though they were mistakes, they were also a learning process. We learned a lot from this. We've never done furniture before. So this is a really good experience for us to get an opportunity to know what kind of woods to use, what kind of cutting speeds to use. All the different things we learned along the way are part of the path of an inventor. Stop, hold on, we're gonna just use this as a table. All right, turn it around. We only need four, right?
Oh yeah.
A little machinist trick that we use for setting the tool bit height is we use a piece of paper as a feeler gauge and we put it between the cutting tool and the wood. And this will tell us how close the tool is to the actual cutting surface. So watch as Denny lowers it slightly, and he'll keep lowering it until the paper catches. It's coming down, you just can't see it. Here it comes, it's up right there. I could say that our first attempt went great, but as you know from our previous videos, this is probably the fourth or fifth try at getting this chair right. So now that's almost our zero point, and that actually looks pretty good. We're pretty close to the edge. I think we have a little bit of leeway on the bottom, don't we? Okay. The chairs come out really nicely. We've had a little bit of struggles that you haven't seen on camera because we got tired of showing mistakes. But the journey's been worth it, and here is one side of the chair. It looks really good. Denny and I are going to, Denny, if you can give me a hand, we're going to pull it out and take a look. Okay, let me get this one. And there it is. It looks really good. So we're going to cut these pieces off, sand them up, and we'll show you what the chair looks like as we're assembling it. If you remember, we put these nice tabs to hold everything, but now what we do is we take a hacksaw blade and we simply just go down and cut them out really quickly. It won't take long at all. We just kind of go down them. And here's our first piece. It's come out really nice. Nice clean finish. We'll sand it up and it'll look great. We could just use a router bit and a hand router to do this, but I don't have one here, so we're doing it by hand. And you don't want to get impatient because we will split the wood and it just won't look nice. So there you go. That was the last one. So there's the chair, and now we'll just sand it off. Normally what would happen is you would take a router and just go around it really quick, but this edge is so nice that there's really no need to for this. Again, this is the prototype, and we're gonna put it together real quick and then take it apart. I'm just sanding the edge. You just grab the edge with the sandpaper and it takes off all that. And we're gonna start putting it together. It should go together pretty easily. Okay, we're gonna do one side first. And that one. You wanna hold that? Okay, so we just line them up. Might take a little trial and error. Well, here, the problem is now we're towards this. And got that one. I'm gonna line this one up. You know what? This didn't come out too bad, did it? It looks pretty good. You know, I'm gonna give it a try. It's really sturdy. I'm proud of this. I know it was a simple project that turned into a very long one, but again, this gives you an idea of the things that you can make and sell online. Yes, it took us a while to learn, but in the end, it's really not that difficult. We went from this test model to this chair, and it's really not bad. Join us next time on Invention Therapy, where we come up with something else that's really interesting to build.